delicious Singapore hawker food at Geylang Bahru Food Centre. Welcome to another food adventure with Getting Lost. We are back at Geylang Bahru Food Centre to try all the delicious good food there, because in our last visit, I found out there's still lots of good food to eat. And to find out what are the good food I ate there, you just have to tune in after the introduction. Welcome back, and as I told you earlier, we are at Geylang Bahru Food Centre, which is near Geylang Bahru and Kallang Bahru Road. And here, surprisingly, during our last visit, we covered a few good foods, and there's still more good food to eat here. So, what is there to do except to eat more and more and more? And a bit more after that. And as I was walking around, I found this shop called Hui Wei Chili Ban Mian. And here, they sell ban mian and also various types of noodle dishes. They have tom yum. But what I tried here, which I think is their signature dish, which is in the name, is their chili ban mian. And it cost me $4. Here's the dish. You have, first of all, noodles. Noodles made in the store. So it's handmade noodles. And the noodles here has a nice firm texture to it. It's served together with a nice bowl of soup. And here you can see there are meat. And then you have anchovies, you have deep fried shallots. You have a bit of vegetable, a bit of coriander on top as a garnish. And then you have, first of all, minced meat sauce. And the base sauce you see underneath the noodles here is actually a dark soya sauce, which is a bit sweet. And it goes very well with the noodles. And you also have the noodles. And you also have a minced meat kind of mixture there, which they put it onto the noodles. And at the right, at the diagonally the corner there, is the chili oil. And I asked for normal spicy. So for normal spicy, she put in 2 teaspoons full of the chili oil. Man, the chili oil here, even though I asked for normal spicy, is really spicy. That's a very good spicy kick. For those people who like spiciness, you'll like that. And look at the egg. To get the egg there, and it also has a very nice chili flavor to it. Good, nice, firm bite texture noodles, delicious. And then you have that texture of the noodles contrast together with the minced meat and the crispy fried anchovies, and all this together brought together by the spicy, addictive, super flavorful look. After I mix everything up, everything all changed to a nice reddish color chili oil, which is spicy but still has a nice good flavor to it. And this is a very good dish. And if you like things spicy, this is the dish for you. Another thing you can try here is actually a dish from this stall called Haji Carrot Cake. And here they sell carrot cake. You have the 2 versions. The white one, which I recently learned is the Teochew version of carrot cake, and the black carrot cake, which is the Hokkien version. And here at this shop, they allow you to actually have a mixture of both, which cost me $5. First thing before we go is, I do not know how they do it, but this carrot cake here, the carrot cake by itself has a very nice flavor to it, has a very nice taste. So when you add in together with whatever ingredients, it does taste good. First of all, the top one is the black carrot cake, which is dark because they put in a sweet dark soy sauce on it. It's nice, it's sweet, it has a very comforting feel to it, very familiar with expected flavors. And then at the bottom part is the white carrot cake, which has a very nice good egg layer on top. For the carrot cake, it's more like a omelette with a carrot cake filling, more savory taste. But somehow, when you eat together, the black and the white, it just together, when you eat it together, it has a very nice interplay of sweet and savory flavors that I quite enjoy, quite delicious and quite yummy. Another surprising find that I found at this food center is from this shop called Lo Sing Kim that sells mee rebus, nonya mee siam, and they also barbecue like sweet meat here. But what I tried here is their nonya mee siam, which I haven't tried before. It cost me $3. First of all, when I tasted it, it had a mild taste. It doesn't have the refreshing sour taste that you expect from a mee siam, but somehow, as you can see, the difference here from normal mee siam is that they have like a crushed peanuts on top and then deep fried shallots and also this sambal here. So when you mix it all up together, somehow together with the mee siam broth, which is mainly when you taste it like dried shrimp taste to it, but somehow when you mix it together, some kind of like voodoo food magic happens and the whole dish changes. When you mix it up together, you get a very rich taste to it, almost like a creamy taste to it, and it coats all the ingredients together and makes it super super yummy. Somehow I do not know how this happened, but when, like I said, when you mix it up all together, it's almost has a rich, creamy, nice mee siam broth that coats all the noodles, all the ingredients together, and oh, so good. Another surprising find and another really good find is this store here that sells Putian food. And here I ordered the Putian lor mee, but they also sell Putian bee hoon. They also sell Putian with rice cake, which I find it would be quite interesting. But I just ordered this for $4, the Putian lor mee, and I didn't regret it because this is one of the better Putian lor mees that I have ever eaten for two reasons. First of all is the broth, second of is because of the noodles. First, the broth. The broth here is heavenly. It's so good. It's so flavorful. It's like having the sea in your mouth. It has a very good seafood flavor, and the seafood flavor with the hints of the sea in it. Very delicious, very good. You know, when you taste it, you can almost feel like you're at the beach. And then all the ingredients are fresh and delicious and goes very well together. It coats, it's a slightly starchy broth that coats all the ingredients very well, very delicious, very good together. And the second part that I really like here is the noodles. The noodles has a very nice chewy texture. It has excellent mouthfeel. When you bite into the noodles has a good bite texture to it. Chewy, firm, delicious. Oh, it makes me hungry just looking at it again, because like I said, this is one of the better Putian noodles I've eaten at the food center. And it's just so good, so delicious, so flavorful. It just comforts you right down to the core. And lastly, we are at this store called Ding Xiang Mei Shi. And here, they sell a variety of dumplings and noodles. And here, they make the noodles and the dumplings in store handmade. So first of all, I ordered their jajangmyeon or their mincemeat paste noodles, which cost me $4. So what you have when you taste first of all is the sauce. The sauce, you can taste a nice preserved bean paste taste to it, which is slightly spicy and has a nice thick starchy mincemeat sauce that they put on the noodles. The noodles here, like I said, since it's made in store, is handmade and it has a good texture to it. But I felt the previous noodles, the texture was much better. This one was just okay. But one thing I really like here is their generous amount of noodles, generous amount of sauce, and generous amount of mincemeat in the sauce. And overall, a very good bowl of noodles. And another item that I ordered is their xiaolongbao or their dumpling, their soup dumpling. They have a few other versions of dumplings that they sell at this store, but I decided to order this one. This dish cost me $4. So what you have here is you have dumplings, which is filled with filling, and also soup. First of all, I must say, they actually fold these dumplings very well. The texture of the skin, nice and thin, and still firm enough that you do not break it with your chopstick. And you also have a little saucer there of vinegar and ginger. So that is what you dip your dumplings into. And here, the dumplings, when you bite into the dumplings, you get a explosion of porky goodness in your mouth. And the top of the dumpling is also not too thick. So I must say, this is also a very good, a compliment with my noodles. So a very good xiaolongbao to try if you like xiaolongbao. And if you need to get your xiaolongbao fix, this is the place to come and try. And so, this is our food adventure here at Geylang Bahru Food Center. I sure hope you enjoyed it because I did. And surprisingly, I found a lot of interesting food, a lot of good food, and surprisingly, a place that will not disappoint you if you come here to eat, because there's lots of variety and the food here is good. But my suggestion is come here for an early lunch, because some of the foods here do sell out or do close after lunch. And before you go, please do me a favor, please help me by liking my video, sharing my video, and subscribing to my channel. And lastly, but most importantly, the thing that you have to do is to join me for my next food adventure. See you there. Yes, you. Bye bye.